Well, less than 1 minute before the start of the second race on Tuesday, I think it's July 9th, and we've had major oscillations. Right now, we're in a left-hand shift. We have moved the mark and adjusted the line, but it was more for a right-hand shift. But the pin is, at any rate, way favored, and you can tell that by the most of the fleet heading down there. Frank's, I believe that's Frank, 57. Not sure. Maybe that's Dave Bryant. Quigley's headed down there. Matt Flynn, Tax. He's gonna. 2-1, all clear. So, it's attack. It's attack. And hopefully the wind shifts back to the left, because right now the boats are fetching. And I'm not sure if we can continue this race the way it is. And we'll see. I'm sorry, I'm sighing, because the wind is just so fickle right now, guys. It hasn't settled in at all. And so we'll see. It's pretty dead up there at the pin. It's not a fetch anymore, thank goodness. But I'm kind of hoping for that righty to come back. Even the boats that started at the pin are not fetching. Not an endorsement from the race committee. And these guys are showing a righty as they sail off. Bob Perry, and there's Alan up there, kicking butt right now. He started dead last in the. He was over early and won that last race. So, go, get on you, Alan. It's a beautiful thing. Well, as the wind has died, the good news is the course is a little more square. It's going downwind in this light air. It's a reach thing. It's hard to go directly downwind, although the tide is going out. And so that does help you. 56 over here on the downwind right is seem to be going slow, but heading more towards the line. 60 over there is on a tight reach. Where is 60? But going not towards the line. So that's a bit of an issue, so we'll see.
Going on once here or twice, or?